Pretty thing, that IVR. I think so, too, if I bet on it. Say, did you hear? The old man who owns IVR had a heart attack.
Really? When?
Just after she crossed the finish line.
Must have been the shock of winning.
I hear he was an old fellow.
Yes, he used to be a college professor.
Well, I guess I might as well cash these in, huh?
Be back in a minute.
Colonel Albright.
Oh, hello, Wallace.
How's Dr. List?
He's dead.
Oh, that's tough.
Well, at least he went out a winner. Who gets IVR?
His estate, I suppose. Dr. Rice is bringing his papers and other belongings to my office now.
You mind if I tag along?
Why?
Well, to tell you the truth, I'd like to own that, Billy. I've been watching her all season.
This is hardly the time to go into that. A man has died, Wallace.
In case of accident, notify Miss Leslie Hale.
Such a sweet person. Yes, that's right. 450 Emerson Drive, Boston. Isn't that strange? I couldn't think of 450 Emerson Drive. Well, I won't keep you any longer, Doctor. Thank you and goodbye.
Goodbye.
Your fencer, will you? We don't lose much time, do we?
No, we don't, do we? What do you think she'll bring at auction?
IVR? 20, 30 grand?
Well, lay off then. You haven't got that kind of dough.
I can always get a steak.
You do it, I'll outbid you, no matter how high you go.
And I'm trying to get a meal ticket so I can eat now and then.
You know how you could eat all the time.
I'm not that hungry.
Well, you can't blame a gal for trying.
Hey, kid. You're going about this the wrong way. If this Hale woman doesn't know what the filly's worth, a telegram's going to give her ideas. We'd be a lot better off not outbidding each other.
You know, we might be at that.
So let's don't, okay?
I promise.
Hey, come with me while I cash my ticket, hmm?
And burn up with jealousy? I will not. Uh-huh. Messenger, would you please send this telegram for me as soon as you possibly can?
Certainly, miss, right after the last race. Oh, thanks a lot.
Hey, messenger. Mrs. Brand gave her wire to you, didn't she? The one to Boston, I mean. Hale Emerson Drive, Boston.
That's right.
Well, she asked me to get it back from you. She changed her mind.
Yes, sir.
Here.
Gee, thanks.
Hale will give you 5 minutes.
Thank you.
is the gentleman who insists on seeing you, Miss Hale.
I'm sorry to intrude, but...
What do you want, sir?
Well, may I offer my condolences? You see, I was an old friend of Dr. Leslie.
I would expect a friend of my late brother-in-law to force his way into my house on the Sabbath to discuss a horse.
Well, at least I'm glad you're willing to discuss it.
I have here a document sent on by Dr. Leslie last week.
Oh, registration papers.
Yes, those of the animal in question, endorsed.
Well, that simplifies everything.
Young man, the fact that I want to get rid of the beast as soon as possible does not becloud my good judgment. I know its value.
Oh, I'm not going to belittle the filly. She's a fair sprinter. Just a little weak in the leg bone, and there are a couple of knots that might be stacked. Not bad, if it weren't for her wind. You know, a slight case of the heave.
That is your concern.
Well, how much do you want for her?
I won't take a cent less than $750.
What?
I remember a roan mare my niece rode as a child. She was gentleness itself, and I gave $600 for her. One might argue that there is a slight difference between a racehorse and a saddle mare.
One might argue the difference is more than slight.
Perhaps. But I am quite sure the animal is worth at least $500. Now, don't haggle, young man. That is my final price.
I'll take it.
Very well. There are the papers.
Thank you, Miss Hill.
Kind to have the check made out to the Transcendental Home for Retired Gentlewomen.
Yes, Miss Hill.
Good day to you.
Good day to you, Miss Hill.
Come in. Oh, did you bring my laundry?
No, sir. Just your parlor car reservation and your bill.
Get her, will you, son?
Hello. Yes. Who? Well, just a moment, please. There's a Miss Leslie Hale at the desk.
Oh, somebody must have told her.
She wants you to come down to the lobby immediately.
Well, she does, does she?
The best defense against an old battle axe like that is offense. Hello? You tell Miss Leslie Hale if she wants to see Mr. Wallace, she'll have to come up to his room. When does my train leave?
In 25 minutes.
Good. Dig up my laundry and have a cab stand by. I have a hunch I'll want to get out of here in a hurry.
Right.
In a moment. So now, Miss Hale, what can I do? I beg your pardon. I was expecting a Miss Hale.
I am Miss Hale.
Not the Miss Hale I met this morning.
That was my aunt, Miss Martha Hale, whom you so contemptibly cheated while I was at church.
Oh, excuse me. Well, please, won't you sit down?
If I had been there, this unpleasantness would never have occurred.
I would call this far from unpleasant.
You took advantage of an elderly woman.
With a whim of iron. I see you've noticed it, too.
Unless you return the registration papers or agree to a fair price, I shall be forced to call the district attorney, who is a very old friend of the family.
Well, that, as they say, is a horse of a different color. What would you say is a fair price, Miss Hale?
Well, my aunt asked $500. I want exactly twice that amount. $1,000.
$1,000?
$1,000 to check all the papers, if you please.
You will regret this.
I think not.
Okay, will cash do?
Yes.
You're a better horse trader than your aunt.
Thanks. I'm sorry I had to threaten you, Mr. Wallace.
Are you?
Well, perhaps this will teach you not to go around trying to swindle helpless women. Goodbye.
Wait. No, I can't do it. It's like taking candy from a baby. Abiar's worth a lot more than $1,000.
What?
Have lunch with me and we'll start from scratch. Hmm?
Lunch? Oh, no, certainly not. How much more?
Here's your laundry. Your cab is waiting.
Out of my way, son.
I can't believe it. $10,000 for a horse?
That's because you don't know thoroughbreds.
But what makes them so different from, say, my old roan mare?
The same things that make one woman stand out above all others. Breeding, intelligence, conformation. She should be well ribbed up with long, straight legs. Wide between the eyes and deep, very deep, through the heart.
Thank you for being so honest with me. About the money, I mean.
Well, I haven't been completely honest with you yet. There's lots more about IBR. Have dinner with me and we'll discuss it further.
Oh, no, I couldn't. $20,000. Even for a thoroughbred, even for Abby R.
Oh, but it's worth it to me.
It would pay off the mortgage on the home.
No kidding. Do the retired gentlewomen really get it?
Mm-hmm.
Your aunt must be very generous with money.
Not always. She just doesn't approve of where this money came from.
Oh, your uncle was the black sheep of the family.
My Aunt Martha feels his life was haphazard, undignified.
How do you feel about dignity?
I think it's very important.
I knew it looks good.
If you'll put me in a cab, please.
Well, let me walk you home. There's more about IBR.
No, Jock, I won't allow it. I can't believe that IBR or any other horse is worth $30,000. $30,000.
She'll win twice that in her first race.
What race?
Kentucky Derby. You're going to see her do it. Sitting beside me at Churchill Downs in May.
I won't be here in May.
Where will you be?
I'll be in London. Getting married.
Getting married? To whom?
His name is William Van Dyke III.
An Englishman?
American.
Why in London, then?
Well, he has to be there for the coronation. He's with our State Department.
A diplomat. I'll bet Aunt Martha's simply crazy about Willie.
And so am I. I can't thank you enough, Jock. I've really got to say goodbye now.
Why goodbye? Just because you're getting married in May is no reason why you can't see me in the meantime.
Certainly not.
That's what I said. Why do you think I came through with 30 grand for the horse? For the horse?
I've been wondering.
Because this is just the beginning for you and me. I've got to go to New York to transfer Abby's registration. It'll take me a few days to raise the dough. But I'll be back by Friday, and we'll have us a whirl.
Certainly. Not.
How do you do? Ooh.
Well, how's New York, Mr. Wallace?
Okay, for what I went for. This time, son, I've really got me a horse.
Good.
Now, where's that coming from?
Right here in the adjoining suite.
Open it up. Kid.
Hello, Stinky.
When did you get in?
Last night. Took me all that time to figure out why Miss Leslie Hale didn't answer my telegram.
I'm one up on you, my pet.
Yeah.
Thank you. Have you met the Hales?
No, the housekeeper told me they'd sailed last night.
Sailed?
Mm-hmm, for England. What's the matter?
Why the little rabbit, the scared little rabbit.
I don't get it.
I think I'm going to enter Abbey R in the Gold Cup at Ascot.
You mean Ascot in England?
That's right.
Are you crazy? You know as well as I do that's a 2.25-mile run with the last half uphill. You can't be serious.
No, of course not. I was just kidding.
Well, I should hope you were. That'd be a heck of a thing to do to a horse. After all, no gal's worth that much.
Here's to a very wonderful kiss. Cost me 30 grand, and I never got it.
Stinker.
Well,
son.
You can't cross here, sir.
But I've got to.
Go through the tube station.
Thank you.
One with milk and sugar, the other straight.
Who's the old souse that takes it straight? Aunt Martha? Why didn't you answer the notes and phone calls I left at the embassy?
It must be obvious why. I just didn't care to see you again.
You mean you were afraid to?
I read you've entered Abbey R at Ascot.
That's right, so we could keep our date to see her run.
I'm going to the races, Jock, but not with you.
Don't tell me Willie would waste a day on the Gigi's.
By the way, which of those old dodos is Willie?
Bill is not here. He was called to the embassy on very important business.
More important than you? Have dinner with me tonight, hmm? There's more about IVR.
Oh, Bill.
Hello, darling. Did you think I'd never get back?
Seemed like ages. Mr. Wallace, this is my fiancé, Bill Van Dyke. Darling, this is the man who bought the horse.
Oh, yes. Glad to know you. How's the filly shaping up?
Oh, she'll laugh herself in.
That sounds like a tip straight from the horse's mouth. If she should be in the money, it fills out.
Could happen.
I don't know. It's a grueling track, and for a filly in the spring.
She's done everything we've asked of her up to date.
I understand her biggest fault is a lack of early speed.
Yeah, but she always comes up from behind.
How is she in distance?
Well, Crusader might have been a better stayer, but for my money...
Bill, darling, our plans are changed for this evening. We're going to the Dwyer's for dinner and then on to the coronation ball.
Sorry, dear, I won't be here.
What?
It's a rotten shame, but I have to leave again.
Madrid? But what am... what the State Department would do without you, darling, I can't imagine.
Perfect diplomat's wife. I've got to go down the hall and talk to Sir John. I'll see you again, Wallace.
Right.
Good luck in the race.
Thank you.
When do you have to leave?
The minute I finish with Sir John.
Oh, dear. You know you're going to miss everything. The Dwyer's dinner and the ball later.
Yes, I know, dear, but you have a good time.
I won't without you.
You run on back and I'll see you before I leave.
Guess that changes your plans.
Not as far as you're concerned.
Okay, be a monkey on a string all your life. So far, Aunt Martha's pulled the string, you've jumped her way. Now Willie's taking over.
I want to jump Willie. Bill's way.
How do you know? Have you ever been free? Did you ever slide down banisters when you were a kid?
There's more to life than sliding down banisters. If you must know, I despise the kind of life you lead.
No dignity, huh?
None at all. Haphazard.
And the chips are on my uppers.
Opportunistic.
Sure, chicken one day, feathers the next.
No rhyme, no reason.
Oh, yes, plenty of rhyme. And here's your last chance to grab a little before you settle down to a long life of reason. I'll be at Claridge's at 10. We'll have a bite, go to the coronation ball. Have supper at the Savoy later. Break the string, monkey, just for tonight.
Manager.
Darling, take me with you.
Sweetheart, that's impossible.
Please, we can be married in Madrid.
Leslie, what's got into you?
Oh, I don't know. I'm afraid.
Oh, you needn't be. I won't be in the slightest danger. Now, you stop worrying.
Don't leave me behind. Please, darling, it's important, really.
But your visa, dear.
You can fix that.
No, I can't. Your passport isn't valid for Spain. After all, you're not a diplomat's wife yet, you know. Be reasonable.
There's such a thing as being too reasonable.
I haven't time to figure that one out. I really have to go. I'll phone you through the embassy the second I land.
Monkey.
Mm-hmm.
Fun?
the best coronation ball I ever went to. And the best supper at the Savoy. And the best dinner.
Worth the row with Aunt Martha?
Oh, I simply explained that I'm old enough to choose my own friends now, and there's no reason why Bill should object.
There hasn't been. So far.
And there won't be. Promise me that, or I won't see you again.
You'll see me again. And again.
Who are you, Jock?
The prodigal son who's never gone home.
Where's home?
A Maryland farm that's falling apart.
Who's there?
Hardly anybody now, a few colored people. I brought Doc Kilburn over with Abby R. He was my father's old trainer and vet. You'll meet him in, oh, about 5 minutes.
Abby R, too?
Mm-hmm. Well, what do you think of her?
Looks like a champion to me.
Gonna take a champ to beat her. It's just time to see you work out.
Oh, wonderful.
Want to clock her?
Sure. Come on, hop up on the fence.
On the fence?
Sure, you've got to be a fence sitter to clock a horse.
Oh.
No, not that way. Turn around.
Oh. Well, what do I do now?
Just swing around.
Are you ready?
Let her go.
All right, break.
Shh. Come on, baby, let her roll. Pick him up, Abby R. Pick him up. That a girl. Did you see how she...
Oh, I missed it. I missed it. Come on, Abby R. Pick him up. Break those legs. Oh, you wonderful filly.
Wow. You did that half in 48 and a fifth. What a workout.
She's ready, isn't she?
Oh, as ready as she'll ever be.
Oh, Jock, I'm so happy.
What a fence sitter you turned out to be.
Thank you. Oh, I've got to get back to London. I promised Aunt Martha I'd help choose bridesmaids' dresses.
Tomorrow.
Oh, I've been saying tomorrow now for 2 weeks.
Well, then another day won't matter. Hey, I want to show you the most beautiful yearling in the world. Hold them a minute.
Oh, he is beautiful, and he's big, isn't he?
He had the advantage of being an early foal. See what a good head and eye he's got? And these long, sloping shoulders.
He's deep through the heart, too, isn't he?
Yes, Miss Valiant's a good colt.
Good? Oh, he's superb. I'm going to buy him. Please tell Sir Richard I'll be around with the cash the day after the Gold Cup.
Right, sir.
What if Abby R doesn't win?
Oh, she'll be in the money.
Jock, I have a few $1,000 I can lend you.
Where you're concerned, Monkey, I do the staking. Hey, look.
Are they really gypsies?
Sure. They travel around peddling, picking hops during the season, doing all sorts of odd jobs. But they're never too busy to lay off for the races.
Molinero, molinero, deja la rueda moler.
Good evening.
Tell your fortune, my lady.
He doesn't need you for that.
everything could stop right now. Never change. Stay like this forever.
It can be better than this. Come away with me, Monkey. To the Argentine. I'm leaving right after the Ascot. We'll start Aviar at Palermo, hit the high spots. And come the first of the year, we'll head for the States with Valiant.
What are you talking about, Jock?
About us.
That's unthinkable.
Is it? Is it?
This isn't me. It can't be me.
But it is. For the first time, it's you. Off the string and free.
Get in.
This morning, shortly after you left.
Oh, I came out to talk Aviar. As a matter of fact, I've been coming out practically every morning.
Yes, I know.
Aunt Martha's been phoning you, hasn't she?
Frequently.
Behind my back.
It sounded last night as if I'd better come home, quick.
Bill, I'm so mixed up, I don't know. Will you tell me what I should do?
You're not a child, Leslie. You've got to make up your own mind.
Hi, Van Dyke. How'd you find us?
Your man helped me.
Oh, good old Doc. Always dependable. How's the State Department?
We managed to get along.
Now it's your turn to ask me about the race. It's in the bag.
Hello, Doc.
Your coat.
I'll do that.
I'll pick you up in the morning, usual time.
Not tomorrow, Jock.
But the next day's the big race.
And a week later, I'm marrying Bill. And in the meantime, I've got an awful lot to do. So I won't be able to see you again, Jock. Good luck to you and Aviar. Goodbye, Doc.
Bye, Miss Leslie.
Behind.
brakes broken down.
And now precipitation and Cecil are fighting for me. Royal H is the boss comes to take four. And me dropping back the fifth.
I haven't got a chance.
Abby R is out of the race. It's hard luck. He's running splendidly. Had a good chance to win.
It is Abby.
Now they're approaching the finish line. And it's precipitation.
Precipitation. That's his second. First
to
third, isn't it?
Well, that's what makes horse racing.
Oh, it was a great race, wasn't it?
Fine.
Who did you have?
Precipitation.
Oh, great. You're a winner then. Shame about AVR.
Yes. I wonder what happened.
I don't know.
Leg look when you loaded her.
Oh, she's all right. The fever and swelling ought to all be gone by the time we reach Buenos Aires.
What was that?
Take a look for yourself.
Valiant, where did you come from? Who brought you aboard?
I did. And I've also been waiting around in this filthy hole, wasting sympathy on you, while you were out doing the town.
Captain says you go on shore now, miss. Please, hurry, hurry.
All right. Goodbye, Doc.
You get your way, Detective. You came and you waited, Monkey. Why?
Because I felt sorry for you. Let me go.
Why?
Because I wanted you to have the colt to remember me by. Please.
Why?
Because...
Say it, Monkey. Say it or I'll say it for you. You love me.
Yes, I do.
And if you're smart, you'll get off this boat and run back to Willie as fast as your legs will carry you. I'm no good for you, Monkey. My life is as screwy as you said. But I like it that way. There's no use kidding you. I won't change. I never thought I'd ask any girl to marry me. And I warn you, you'll be making the biggest mistake of your life if you do.
Oh, John!
Hurry, miss, hurry. Please hurry, miss, or I'll lose the time.
Go ahead and cast off. You've got another passenger. And tell the captain to make it snappy. He's got a wedding to perform. Dust off your best bib and tucker, Doc. You're giving the bride away.
Oh, Doc.
The newlyweds are here. Senor Wallace and his bride have just arrived.
Oh, como le va, Hernandez?
It is good to see you once again, Senor Wallace, and to welcome la señora. May I offer my felicitations?
Thanks. Get my cable all right?
Oh, si, senor. The bridal suite is ready.
Have my trunks arrived from England yet?
Oh, si, senora Wallace. Since a week. I took the liberty of having them unpacked.
Thank you.
This way, please.
Some of my old stable mates. Sarah Crittenden and Cliff Beaumont. Ella May and Julian Scott.
Julian, isn't she divine? Much happiness.
Well, Kit! Cliff, do the rest of the honors, will you?
Wallace, may I present Mrs. Fowler?
Kiss me, you big oaf, and tell me you missed me.
I couldn't eat or sleep.
well, well. So at last, Jock Wallace picks himself a winner.
I want you to meet her. Monkey, this is Kitty Brandt. Pay no attention whatsoever to anything she does or says. She's a horrible liar, a terrible flirt, an awful cheat, but a wonderful friend.
We just flew down to say hello. So, hello.
Hello.
Champagne?
Jock! Don Umberto, quanto gusto. Como está usted?
Oh, muy bien, gracias. Y muy sorprendido de tu matrimonio.
No más sorprendido que yo. Le presento a mi señora. Darling, I'd like you to meet Don Umberto Barcares, an old and warm friend of my father's.
And of his father's son. It is an honor to welcome you.
Thank you very much. How did you all know that we were coming?
Didn't Jock tell you he'd cable Kitty?
Why should he? A man and a woman ought to have a few secrets from each other. I want to talk to you.
May I offer you some refreshment?
Somebody better. Jock's neglecting her already.
What a scream, sweetie.
Adelante.
I'm terribly impressed with your Spanish, darling.
You are? Thank you. Hola. ¿Quién habla?
Wonderful.
Muy bien. Ponelos allí. Pues sí. Subiremos enseguida.
Señora Brandt and her party await us in the starlight room, madam.
Oh, dear. Already? Why, Jock, I thought you'd finished shaving.
I have, practically. You look nice. Why don't you just wear that? Something simple, alluring. Very alluring.
Oh, Jock, we've got to hurry.
Yes, ma'am.
Go on.
Oh, look on the couch in the living room.
Flowers? For me?
No, got them for the bellboy. Thought he looked unhappy.
Oh, they're lovely. But Jock...
Don't mention it. Come to the dinner. The monkey, how about putting the cufflinks in my shirt,
Jock, I've been thinking.
What about? Those carefree days of your girlhood when you had only yourself to dress?
Oh, please be serious a minute, Jock. I mean about Kitty Brandt and Don Umberto. They're so wealthy, Jock, and so extravagant. Why, in the 5 hours we've been here, we've run up bigger bills than Aunt Martha and I used to spend in a whole week. How are we going to pay them?
Lesson number one. In my racket, the time to act prosperous is when you're broke.
Flowers and things like that. Couldn't we do without them until we get on our feet?
You're never going to do without anything, monkey.
You made me drop your cufflink.
What cufflink?
Oh, Jack, come on. We must hurry. Oh, your cufflink.
Why don't you look under the bed? What's the matter, monkey? I just kissed your strawberry, Mark. I love it.
I almost had it taken off once. I'm glad now that I didn't. Now will you get dressed?
Hey, what about my cufflink?
Find it yourself. Who used to fix your shirts for you before we were married?
Oh, lots of people. The lady upstairs, the lady downstairs. The lady across the hall. Kindly souls. Always ready to lend a helping hand to a poor bachelor. Hey, monkey.
Yes?
Come and tie my tie for me.
Can't you do anything?
Nope. Not while I have you around.
You know, sooner or later, you're going to have to learn to do this for yourself.
You talk too much.
Now, Jock, stop it. Stand still.
Don't you like me?
There. Very good, if I do say so myself.
Hey, how about handing me my dinner jacket?
You know, what you need is a nurse.
Thank you.
Oh, my goodness, look at the time. We have to hurry.
Well, I'm ready. You're the one who's holding things up.
That's gratitude. Why, Jock, you look beautiful.
You're beautiful. I'm really very handsome.
Of all the conceit. Here, hook me up.
And who used to do this before I did, may I ask?
Oh, the gentleman upstairs and the gentleman downstairs and the gentleman across the hall.
Liar. Neither of us ever lived before we were married, and you know it.
That's right. Oh, Jock, they're waiting.
Let them wait.
Listen to Valiant. Isn't he wonderful? You be quiet, boy. It's Abby R. who needs us now.
You all ready, Doc? Everything's set, just waiting on you.
Hello, Abby girl. Will it hurt her very much?
Well, I will give her something to deaden the pain.
Poor girl. I think she understands.
I'm sure she understands. Well, let's get started.
Come on, Abby girl. Hand me that hypodermic, will you? Lie on the table.
Right.
The neck cradle.
Doesn't bother her. Keeps her from getting her head low enough to tear up her bandages. Take it easy, Abby girl. Want to come out to Don Umberto's with me?
Now? What for?
Kitty Brandt's heading out that way. She'll get the pick of his coats if I don't beat her to it.
But, Jock, we can't afford another horse now.
Now, let me worry about that.
But you don't worry. Not about anything. The feed bill, the hotel bill, or anything else.
I'll pay eventually.
Oh, Jock, how can you act as if you happen to care in the whole world?
I haven't. Strangely enough. Coming?
No, I'm going to stay with Abby R., and I should think you'd want to, too.
Well, why? There's nothing more we can do for her now. Well, I'll see you later, honey.
See you later, monkey.
Mighty good prospects, Don Umberto. Why, there's Jock.
Senor Jock.
Pablo, how have you been?
Oh, welcome back. We have missed you, my friend.
What's this I hear about you winning 3 races in a row?
Oh, no, it's nada, senor.
Nothing, eh? How about riding Aviar for me in the Gran Premio?
Oh, senor, if it could be arranged.
It will be. Has Senora Brandt been around here yet?
Si, está with Don Umberto.
Now, there goes the pick of the crop.
Si.
What do you mean, si?
The pick of the crop is in the east pasture, Senor Jacques.
Well, get on. What are we waiting for?
Where are they going? Hey, what's up?
Nothing. Come. We shall go back to the house.
What are you hiding over there?
Nothing that concerns you, senora.
No? Just the same, I think I'd better have a look. But never mind. Follow Mr. Wallace.
Beautiful bunch of yearlings. Look at that little chestnut rascal go. He really looks like a champion.
Oh, see, that's Relampago.
What do you call him?
Relampago. It means lightning.
It suits him.
Oh, so is temper.
Buenas tardes.
¿Qué tal? ¿Qué te dije a vos? I gave you express orders not to bring anyone here.
I don't blame Pablo Don Alberto. It was all my doing.
Nevertheless, he's in strict disgrace.
Then you won't mind if I take him on to ride Abiar?
There was no need to corrupt him. I myself intended suggesting it.
Look at this colt.
He's full of the old Nick, isn't he?
High spirits, that is all. Oh, yes, that's Maria Visto, eh? He understands every word I say to him. No estiesto? If one speaks to him gently, he'll obey. But if one speaks to him unkindly, he's as stubborn as a mule.
Name your price, Don Umberto.
Oh, no, you don't. Just because you sneaked around and saw him first.
Pardon, Senora Jock. This one I have a fancy for myself.
For 20 years, my father bought horses from you. But now, when I, his only son...
No, Jock, no. Pablo, I give you. But this colt I keep for myself.
Look at that baby go.
Jock's father gave it to me the day Fancy Free hung up the mile and a quarter at Pimlico. That was the year we remodeled the stables. Here it is. That's the front of the house.
That looks like Jock.
Jock's father.
Really?
Here's Jock.
What on earth is he doing up there?
Hanging by his toes from the balcony.
He hasn't changed much, has he?
Oh, not much. He wanted it that way, and his mother always saw he got what he wanted. You know, she was lost on the Lusitania.
I didn't know that.
Hmm.
When did his father die?
1928. I don't think he ever got over the loss of Jock's mother.
It's a beautiful place.
It don't look much like that now. It's all run down.
Could be restored, though, couldn't it?
Yeah, but Jock never wanted to be tied down. He ought to quit gallivanting around. Settle down. Get the Wallace stables to going again. Breed horses. Begin with Abby R.
Don Alberto doesn't think we even ought to try to run Abby R. Has she got a chance at the Grand Premio, Doc?
Can't tell. The leg healed. I think I'll have a look at her. Have an apple?
No, thanks.
Mm-hmm. My old Kentucky home. Hello, my Abby girl. Hello, my baby. By and by, hard times, comes a knocking at the door. Weep no more, my weep no more again. For my old Kentucky home.
Today's the day, eh, Doc?
Take it easy, Abby girl.
Don't worry.
Come on, honey. Keep your fingers crossed.
Oh, Jock, are you sure she's all right?
Wise, Doc?
Oh, sure. I told Pablo to just gallop her slowly.
Jock,
What'd you do with it?
145.
145?
That's wonderful, isn't it? He's really lonesome.
I told Pablo to let her out.
She looks ready to me. What'd you do with it?
Perdón, senor. What did our horse clock this afternoon?
She did the mile in 140, driving.
Ejercitó la milla en 140.
¿Cómo eloge, amigo?
¡Qué macanudo! This race, I tell my wife, it's in the bag.
Oh, I'm tired. All I want is a hot bath, dinner, and bed.
Well, move over, baby. You have your tub, and I'll order dinner. I know just what you want. Hey, the gang's here.
Well, here they are.
Oh, it's about time. We thought you'd moved into those stables.
Why do you have to tuck that horse in personally every night?
I declare she's more trouble than a baby.
How would you know?
I guess I had a baby once.
What baby?
She must mean Julian.
Never mind, Julian. I bet that you were a very cute baby.
Once.
I'll see you all later. I'm going to bathe and lie down for a while.
Oh, Leslie, aren't you going to stay and play gin with us?
Come on, Jock. I'll play you a little gin.
Okay, kid, you're on.
I didn't mean to wake you up.
You didn't. What time is it?
3:25. Now, what did I do with my purse?
It was on the bed. Oh, here it is.
Wish I'd gone to bed early. But I have rotten luck.
That doesn't look like bad luck to me.
This? Oh, Jock just paid me this on account.
Is he hot tonight? Simply can't lose.
Why, on one hand, he only had...
What do you mean, Jock paid you on account?
What do I mean? Oh, it never occurred to me you didn't know.
You mean Jock's been taking money from you?
Oh, now, don't put it that way, monkey. Jock and I have been living in each other's pockets for years, staking and double-crossing one another. As a matter of fact, he gave me my start. I'll never forget it. I was just 17. It was my first big party on somebody's yacht. And believe it or not, I still knew from nothing. Anyway, the minute I set eyes on Jock, I knew that...
Please, I'd rather not hear about it.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
And don't ever call me monkey again.
Fine. If you want it that way.
Huh. Hey, what's going on in here?
You'll find out, Stinky, in due time.
Have a good sleep.
You must be hungry. Skipping dinner?
How long have we been living on Kitty's charity?
Oh. So that's what you two have been going around about. Now, what's wrong with taking a little loan from an old friend,
Friend? She's in love with you. You were in love with her once. Maybe you still are.
Don't be a little dope. Here, take one.
Oh, Jock, why didn't you tell me you were so desperate for money?
Nothing desperate about it.
I could have wired Aunt Martha. I still can. She'll help us.
Now, look, monkey. I told you before, where you're concerned, I do the staking.
On her money? Oh, Jock, we can't take it. Not now.
What's so different about now?
We're going to have a baby. Don't you want?
Oh, sure, sometime, but...
You don't want it. You don't.
Sure I do, honey. It's just that... Well, it's sort of a shock. I was kind of bowled over at first. It's just that I wasn't thinking of anything like that. But if that's what you want, monkey, why, sure, I'm tickled pink, honest.
It's not true. I can see it.
But it is, I swear it. I love you, monkey.
Oh, Jock! Please take me home.
Where, your Aunt Martha?
No, to your home in Maryland. I know how it used to be. And I've dreamed of how it can be again. Oh, Jock, please let's go back and start living like human beings again. You can do everything your father did. You can breed horses.
You've been talking to Doc Kilburn.
Jack, please. I can't live this kind of life, and you can't go on like this forever. There comes a time when people have to grow up. Can't you realize that?
I suppose so. All right. If Abby wins the big race, I'll take you home on the first boat.
If she wins?
She will. Then there'll be plenty of money to fix up the farm the way you want it. But until then, till after the Grand Premio, play it my way, will you, Monkey? Pablo, te voy a decir por última vez, como tenés que...
Remember what I told you? You've got to win, Abby. Everything depends on it. The farm, the future, everything. Oh, Abby girl, do this for me, and I promise you I'll take you back to the farm, and you'll spend the rest of your days in clover. Win for me, Abby girl. Win for me.
Señoras y señores, los caballos salen del palo para correr el gran...
Care to risk another grand, don Humberto?
Sí, hombre, cómo no.
Yes. But I find it in my heart to hope I lose, senora.
Senor Garcia, would you like 500 more?
Sí, senor.
How about you, Senor Lopez? Another 500?
Con mucho gusto, senora.
Oh, Jock, they're ready to start. Please don't make any more bets. Come on.
I hate you take your money like this, boys. You can't say I didn't warn you. Let's all drink to Abby R., one of the immortals.
I won't drink to that nasty beast.
You wouldn't either if she cost you every cent you possessed.
You didn't bet against me, did you?
Julian was positive she'd lose. It's not funny. If you do charter a yacht, Julian and I can't go. I can't even buy a new girdle. And you know I couldn't go on a yachting party without a new girdle.
Well, here, buy yourself a trunk full of two-way stretchers.
Oh, God, darling.
No. Hey, while you're at it, you might as well get Julian one.
Hola, Pablo.
Hey, Pablo. Everybody drink up to Pablo, the greatest little rider of both the Americas. Hey, what's the matter with Giorgio? Something wrong?
I think so. A Signora Branch, she went to the estancia to see Don Umberto about a lamp ago.
Why, the witch. She's working on him behind my back. Come on, Leslie.
No.
Leslie. Hey, Cliff, get a car. I'll meet you and the gang at the entrance.
That's right.
Oh, what the hell?
Wait a minute.
What's wrong, Monkey? Are you sick?
Yes, sick of those phonies.
Oh, well, Ella May's a feather brain.
What did she mean if you charter a yacht?
Oh, well, I thought a cruise would be fun for you. Do you a lot of good in your condition.
That's just what I need right now, a good case of seasickness. Play it my way until after the big race, you said.
Did I?
You know darn well you did. But you had no intentions of it being any other way but your way.
If you don't want to go on a cruise, you won't go, that's all.
Making grand gestures, throwing your money away.
All right, all right.
I kept my promise. Now you've got to keep yours.
I will, Monkey.
Then forget about Relampago or I'll...
Are you of what?
Don't make me say it, Jock.
Take Senor Wallace up right away, will you, Jose?
Muy bien, señor.
Where are you going?
Out to the estancia to get the colt, if it's not too late.
You don't know how much I appreciate this, Don Umberto.
Buenas, Don Umberto.
Hello, Jock.
Trying to pull a fast one, eh?
Not just trying, Stinky.
Now you have ruined the surprise.
What surprise?
The Senora Brandt persuaded me to sell her the colt.
Want to see the bill of sale?
It's a birthday present for you tomorrow.
What birthday?
What is it? What's wrong?
What so happens that my birthday was 3 months ago.
Oh, how dreadful. Imagine me making a mistake like that. Well, I guess I'll just have to keep a lamp ago myself now.
It's most embarrassing for me.
Oh, forget it, Don Umberto. This is just a little game that Senora Brandt and I often play.
Only this time, it so happens, I won. Going to wish me luck with the lamp ago?
Sure, sure.
Yeah, I know, all of it bad.
I think we could all do with a little refreshment.
Oh, of course, of course. My house is yours.
It's a wonderful moon.
Go away.
It's me, Doc.
Hello, Doc.
Pablo, tell me what happened downstairs. You all right?
Of course, except that I'm getting more furious by the minute.
I don't know as I blame you none, the brainless young whelp. Mind if I smoke?
Why be so formal as to ask? Don't you know that we live in each other's pockets around here?
You know, I was mighty glad for his sake when you married Jock. Even if it was a dirty trick to play on a nice girl like you.
That's what he said that night I brought Valiant to the boat.
Yeah, that boat. That wedding. Married on the high seas by the captain of a freighter. You were a good sport about that wedding, Leslie. After the one you planned, you've been a good sport ever since. Giving up security and everything for a life like this.
You know, Doc, security can be awfully dull at times.
Maybe. But you've certainly done your best to make a go of it with Jock.
Have I, Doc? Have I really, Doc?
You bet you have. And how does he think? Leaves you flat and goes and looks for the horse.
He didn't leave me flat.
He didn't?
No, he asked me to go with him.
Why don't you go then?
Because I lost my temper. Yes, I did, Doc. And then, well, I began issuing ultimatums. He couldn't let me get away with that. Doc Kilbourn, have you been baiting me?
Of course. We let the others dip. You and I'll just nip.
Marvelous, marvelous. Oh, you're a sweet. You've got to speak.
But you want to play.
No!
And this is for stealing your lamp ago.
No! Look at those two.
Yeah, just like old times.
Now, Cliff.
No, Josh, please. My side.
Oh, come on, I'll help you in. Come on. Here. You all right? Oh, come on.
Oh, my side.
What is it, a cramp or your appendix?
I don't know. It just hurts.
Here, put this on. I'll go and get somebody.
Oh, no, don't. I'll be all right. Here, sit down.
Why, you face. I ought to.
That's a long time since you've done that.
Say, what is this, another gag?
We've had a lot of laughs together, haven't we?
Sure.
We'll never be the same again. Not ever.
Hey, since when have you begun weeping in your beer?
I don't dare start. I might not be able to stop.
No, kid.
Oh, just a friendly gesture. Well, goodbye. I beg your pardon.
Leslie! Wait! You and your clowning. Hi, Monkey. Almost packed? You're beginning to look like yourself again. Monkey. You have no idea what these last weeks have been.
Haven't I?
Oh, I didn't mean... I had a long talk with both doctors this morning. They say you're perfectly all right. You can have other children. As many as you want.
I'm leaving you, Jock.
Why?
Why do you imagine?
Well, you haven't even let me explain about Kitty Brand.
I'm not leaving you because of Kitty Brand.
Well, come here.
Stop it, Jock. That's right. Try to get at me that way.
We can't break up like this, Monkey. We love each other.
I found out that love isn't enough. There's got to be a meeting ground for two people to make a go of marriage. And we're as far apart as the poles. We haven't even wanted the same thing. I know in your heart you're really relieved there isn't going to be a baby. That'd tie you down. So would Marilyn. So would... Yes? If you please. Thank you. Bill is on his way up.
Van Dyke?
He flew in yesterday.
You sent for him?
Yes. We're going to the States on the afternoon clipper.
I see. And then what?
I'm going to divorce you, Jock. Come in.
Hello, dear. Wallace?
Two bags, please, Bill.
Wait a minute, Leslie. There's one thing I've got to get straight. Are you sure this is all over, finished?
Of course I'm sure.
I gave you up once. I won't do it again.
I won't change, Bill. I know I won't. But if it seems that I'm going to, don't let me. Let's go home where I belong.
Terminal River gave us this morning.
It ought to be. It's been the same one every Sunday ever since I can remember.
Leslie, how can you talk like that?
Well, you have a visitor.
If it's that man...
Take it easy, Aunt Martha. Oh. Take it easy.
Why, it's Doc Kilbourne. Hello, Doc. It's good to see you.
That goes double.
This is my aunt, Miss Hale.
Howdy, Miss Hale.
And of course you know Bill Van Dyke.
Howdy. See you again, Doc.
Won't you sit down, Doc?
Thanks. Sure hate to butt in like this, but I got to find out what you want me to do with Valiant.
Well, that horse is none of Leslie's affair.
She owns him. Doc signed him over to you the night you left. Told me to bring him on home with Abby R.
Leslie is signing him right back again. You can tell your Mr. Wallace that.
Afraid I can't do that, Miss Hale. I know where Jock is. Do you?
No, but just find Kitty Brandt, and he'll be in the neighborhood.
No, she don't know either. Seen her twice lately, too. Once at Boy, and again at the Albemarle Stakes.
And what has that to do with Leslie?
Just that Leslie's horse, running under Dr. Leslie's old silk, won both starts.
Against Relampago? Oh, I'm glad Valiant beat him.
Valiant could beat anything on four legs this season. There's Kentucky Derby material, or I'm blind.
Oh, Doc.
Yes, sir.
No, I can't have any part of anything to do with Jock, especially horses. You get fond of them, and then something happens, and you get hurt.
You don't stop living just because you get hurt.
Our mind's made up, and that's that.
Well, I'm sure sorry to see you quit. You want me to sell Valiant then, huh?
Yes, if you get a good offer.
Already had a very good offer. Well, guess there ain't nothing more to say.
I'm sorry, Doc.
Oh, I don't know how to blame you, none. Bye.
I'll see you to the door, Doc.
Doc?
Yeah?
That offer you had for Valiant, was it from a good stable?
Oh, sure. One of the best in the country. Kitty Brandt.
Kitty Brandt? She wants to buy Valiant?
That's it.
I've changed my mind. I'm going to campaign with Valiant.
What's that? You're going to race the animal, you mean?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is the most preposterous. Say something, William.
Why? Why are you going to race him?
Well, I'm certainly not going to let Kitty Brandt have him.
Well, then sell him to somebody else.
No, he's my responsibility. I bought him in the first place, and I'm going to follow through with him.
This is utter nonsense. You're going to marry Bill and settle down.
Well, I can't now, at least not until next year. But in the meantime, I'll run Valiant, and if he's good enough, I'll enter him in the Derby and win.
Dinner is served, Miss Hale.
Put your foot down, William. Don't let her wheedle you into any
such... The soup is getting cold, Aunt Martha.
Please try to understand, dear. This horse means an awful lot to me.
We'll talk about it after dinner.
No, Bill. We won't wait until after dinner. I'm not a monkey on a string any longer. I've made up my own mind.
Well, all right. But I haven't forgotten what you said to me when I brought you home. If it seems I'm going to change, don't let me. I don't intend to let you, Leslie. Race this horse if you're so set on it. But when the time comes, you're marrying me.
Mm-hmm.
find Dr. Kilgorn?
Yes, ma'am. You'll find him right over at the stables there.
Thank you. Did you get my telegram? Oh, what a relief. Doc Kilgorn, did you ever have an offer from Kitty Brand?
Sure I did, but I turned it down long before I told you about it.
Oh, Doc. Abby R. Hello, Abby R. Gee, it's wonderful to see her again, Doc. It's all just the way I imagined it.
Look, here comes the big boy.
All right, did you pull him up?
Oh, he'll do, and how he'll do. Where do we start him, Doc?
Highly on the 7th, juvenile championship stage.
Will Relampable start there, too?
Yep.
Good. Relampago is acting up.
Yes,
what's the matter with that crazy horse, Matt?
You answered yourself, Mr. Frant. It's crazy.
Well, there we go again. That's the third time he's thrown his jockey. Look at that valiant
dog.
Look at Leslie. He's out in front.
Oh, what a horse. Isn't he beautiful?
I wouldn't be at all surprised if Josh wanted them back.
You mean Aviar and Valiant, of course.
Why, of course, darling.
Come on, Valiant. Oh, he's in.
Let's take me all the way. What a horse.
You've had the same trouble with Relampago every time you tried to load him.
Nothing but trouble ever since I bought him. Why, it's Jock.
Hello, Mike.
Hello, Jock.
You need any help? The boss sent me down.
Thanks. I think we better rest him for a minute first. Hold it, boys. Let him settle down.
Hey, Jock!
Hi, kid.
Greetings,
Doc.
Where have you been all these months?
Around. What have you done to Rolampago?
What have I done to him? That's the worst brute I've ever known. Next to you.
He was certainly gentle enough with Don Umberto.
What are you doing around here?
Trying to make an honest dollar.
Not working.
Afraid so.
But what in the world for?
For enough dough to get back to the farm.
And then what?
Raise horses. Maybe breed a line of my own, beginning with Abiar.
Oh, it sounds awful.
We got to get along, Mrs. Brandt, or we'll never make connections with the chief.
All right, all right. Mac, get that crazy fool aboard.
We're doing our best, Mrs. Brandt.
Oh, what I've been through with that beast. And to think I never even would have bought him if it hadn't been for you. But I'll forgive you, Jock, if you come along with us.
Sorry, kid, the boat sailed.
Turning me down, huh? All right, Stinky. Just for old time's sake, I'm going to give you something to remember me by. Rolampago.
Now, wait a minute.
Well, you remember I bought him for your birthday? Well, it's a little late, but he's all yours now. Get aboard, Mac. We're leaving Rolampago here.
Hey, now, listen.
Let's get out of here, Cliff. You're responsible for him now. I'll send his faces to the bow.
Hey, you witch!
That's what you get for saying no! Kiss your bitches. Aren't I, though? But 50 to 1, I get a wire from him before tomorrow. Collect.
We got ourselves something, Pablo.
Ah, gee.
What can be eating you,
eh? Mire, mire, caballo.
Ya que caballo tan pronto viene ahí.
Vamos,
compadre, ¿de dónde habrá venido mi caballo?
Mi boy, oh.
Stay with you, señor Jock.
Ah, de veras ese caballo de...
Pero, señor, ahora... Pablo, did you see how he ran right over to those Mexicans?
Si, senor.
I've got it. Remember the French horse Le Duc who won the Grand Prix in Paris? He was bought by an English syndicate. Never won a race over there. They shipped him back, and in his first start, he won in a walk. That's all that's wrong with him. He's homesick. Come on, Pablo. Oh. ¿Qué te pasa, Roland, Pablo? ¿Por qué estás así tan mañero? ¿Estás extrañando a Don Humberto? Vamos, calmate. Nosotros somos tus amigos, ¿eh? Vamos. Vamos. Vamos, pronto, Lámpago. Oh. Amigos, ahora sé que a mi caballo hay que hablarle en español. Muchas gracias. Pablo, you know what Kitty Brandt has wished on us? Kentucky Derby material. Vamos.
Hola, José. ¿Cómo está mi caballo?
Muy bien, señor Wallace.
¿Cómo está?
Estamos bien, señor
Rosa. Vení. Para vos y los chicos.
What is that, señor
Wallace? Ah, señor Wallace, el caballo está muy contento.
Hey, muchachos. ¿Les gusta mi caballo?
Es bueno. Likes my little brother very much.
Oh. Habla español, no inglés.
I'll be darned, sir. Well, if you're going to train him at the farm, we'll have to take Valiant on to Lexington. Wait a minute, Jock. You enter him in the Derby, you'll be running against Valiant and Leslie.
Not against her, Doc. For her.
I see what you mean.
Thanks, Frazier. There. Well, I guess you know how to ride him by now.
Senor Jacques.
Well, remember to give him his head right from the start. Talk to him, Pablo. Tell him how good he is. Tell him he's among friends, huh? All right, let's go. How are you, Van Dyke?
Fine, thanks. The Lafico looks great.
Well, there's only one entry he's got to watch out for.
It was wonderful the way you figured out what was wrong with Rolampico.
Well, nothing wrong with him, only with the humans around him. Well, I wish you good luck.
Thank you. Good luck to you.
So long, Walt.
Well, Valiant looks in good shape, Doc.
He is, tip top. Give the boy a leg up, will you?
Yeah, sure.
Changed, hasn't he?
Who?
Doc.
Oh, I didn't notice particularly. He's a little thinner, maybe.
No wonder the face he's been hitting the last few months. He's rebooked the farm, you know. Got three new brood mares and half a yard in full.
He must have got a stake from Kitty Brandt.
No, mortgage from the bank.
That is something new.
He won't admit how tough the going's been, but he's fixed everything up just the way you always wanted.
I suppose, as usual, he's put everything he's got in the race.
That's right. If he wins, he's coming after you.
That's ridiculous. What if he doesn't win?
In that case, he loses everything he's got. Farm, Abbey R, everything.
There are 90,000 spectators out here at Churchill Downs today to watch the running of the Kentucky Derby. 90,000 spectators will be watching the two favorites. This is Leslie Wallace's entry.
Here they come now. Valiant's number one.
I wonder how Leslie feels with Jock racing against him.
There's Relampago.
And Relampago, number three.
Doesn't he look simply wonderful?
Certainly does. I think I gave him away.
What's so funny?
Just the way I double-crossed myself. I guess I don't live right.
Today, Jock Wallace brings his father's famous blue and gold silks back to Churchill Downs for the first time in a quarter of a century. Now the horses are at the starting gate. The jockeys are moving
not
in there.
Not a good be in Relampago. Not a good be in Thorpe.
Jockey Ortega is talking, speaking Spanish to that horse as they're getting ready for the start. The crowd is tense. They're moving forward. And they're away. They're away to cool down. The one horse got off to a bad start. I have the champion of the horse.
What's the matter with your horse, Doc? He got away to a bad start.
Where's Valiant?
Bluebell, Mischief Maker, Comet number three, and the Lampago.
Bluebell's really holding that lead.
Yeah, but the Lampago's still in there.
And it's still Bluebell in the lead. Bluebell's holding the lead with Mr. Baker, second and third. Valiant is still trailing. And now Relampago is starting to move up. Relampago is moving up on Comet, moving up on Christian Baker. He's making his finish there. Valiant is still running along behind. He's showing a little action back there now. He's starting to move out. Now, comes Valiant. Valiant's moving up steadily. That great horse is coming out to overcome that bad breaking out at the starting gate.
Come on, Relampago.
Relampago is setting a pace like we've never seen on this mile and a quarter track. A blistering pace up.
Come on, Relampago. What's the matter with him? Has he blown his top? Come on, Relampago. Come on, Relampago.
Connor's still in there in second and third, respectively. Relampago is moving out as they come around into the home stretch. It's Relampago in the lead. Mr. Michael and Comet and Valiant is coming up. Valiant is making his bid. This great champion is starting to roll, ladies and gentlemen. The fans are very excited. Everybody's on their toes now. They're moving forward to watch this.
Look at that Valiant move up.
Relampago is but Valiant is closing in. Valiant's still coming forward, ladies and gentlemen.
Talk to him, Pablo. Talk to him.
Now, Ortega is leaning over, pleading with him. Come on, and now they're neck to neck.
Come on, Relampago. Please, Relampago. Come on, boy. That's it. Stay out in front.
Come on, Valiant.
Valiant and Relampago. Relampago is...
Come on, Relampago. Come on.
Relampago. Ortega's giving him everything he's got. He's talking to him, pleading with him in Spanish. I've never seen a race like this.
Come.
A dramatic finish. These two horses, neck and neck, nose and nose, matching faces.
Come on, Relampago. Come on.
Please. Horse, ladies and gentlemen. And now Valiant's starting to move. Valiant's moving. Moving out in front. And it's Valiant over the finish line. Valiant is the winner. Relampago.
Hard luck, son.
That's what makes horse race.
Come on, smile, darling. You're supposed to have won, you know.
Good ride.
Thank you. Congratulations, Miss Wallace.
Thank you.
Hello, Uncle Jeff.
How's it? Vamos, Diego. Vamos.
Well, we did our best, muchacho. You go ahead and wash out, Pablo. Quiet, Abby girl. Valiant.
Doc, what took you so long? We've been here since yesterday.
What are you doing here? Oh, monkey, I thought I'd lost you.
You'll never lose me. Never again.